So hi guys, we're having a look at the ESP8266 with the motion detector, hc-sr501. I had a few problems getting this going and thought I might put a quick video together just with some tips of what I did. So there's a lot of guides out there that tell you to basically to remove this diode in here and solder stuff onto this voltage regulator or whatever. You don't need to do any of that. I found that you can just connect the 3.3 volts directly to the what they call the H pin here, basically the third pin in from the edge, and then connect your ground and trigger as normal. Then obviously on the ESP board, I've got that connected obviously to the power of the ground, and in my case I've got the GPIO13 here. So that is pretty much all the wiring you need to do, which is pretty simple. But yeah, I had a few hit and misses. I tried cabling all this stuff in and all that stuff, which does work, obviously this is much simpler. You may, depending on your application, need to bridge this, which if you have another little one of these connectors, you can just sort of cut off a bit and stick it in there. So, but anyway, for the moment, I've got it going like this. Now, the other part of the problem, which I've discovered, is that when the Wi-Fi chip is running, from what I can gather, pretty certain on this, it's drawing power whenever it sort of does anything. Now, essentially what you need to do to get this working consistently without false triggering is disable the Wi-Fi when you're not using it. Now, I know that that's not going to be great for, it's not going to work for some applications, especially where you've got like a WebSocket type setup. If you don't do that, then you're going to have to power this device separately, I think. But anyway, so to get this going, just have a quick look at the code here. So you can see what I've got here. So what I've basically got here is the usual serial port setup stuff. Here's my interrupt, where at the moment I'm just doing a little counter, which you can see up in that top right corner. So when I trigger it with some motion, I get another count. But the key here is to turn off the Wi-Fi when you're not using it. So this will essentially allow you to remove the false triggers from my testing. So yeah, look, I might do another video once this is completely finished and up and running, but that was a major milestone for me, getting this working without false triggers. So as you can see, it's now running very nicely. All right, thanks for watching.